Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part four of graphing linear inequalities in two variables, and on this video we graph the following four problems. So here's the first problem: y is greater than negative 1. So the first thing we want to do is graph the line y equals negative 1 and decide whether to make a solid line or a dotted line, right? So we're going to graph y equals negative 1. And now, is that going to be a solution, y equals negative 1? No, because there's no equal sign here. It's strictly y is greater than negative 1. So use a dotted line because it's not part of the solution. Right, now we have to remember how to graph y equals negative 1. Now, this is a line, it's not a point. That's my hint. So go ahead and try that on your own. Get out your own graph paper and try it. All right, y equals negative 1. That means a lot of ordered pairs where the y value is always negative 1. That's this horizontal line down here. Oops. I was supposed to make it a dotted line. Right, so we're going to dot the line. There we go. Convince yourself if you take any ordered pair there, like this ordered pair is 2, negative 1. This ordered pair would be 3, negative 1. This one right here would be 4, negative 1. Notice the y values are always negative 1. If you need a review of how to graph y equals k, where k is an integer, you can go to my videos on graphing. Okay. So now the question is, we have to decide which side of the line to shade. And what do you think? It says y is greater than negative 1. So I want where the y values are higher, right? They're greater. So it seems reasonable they're going to be up here, hopefully, to everybody. But to be on the safe side, let's do a checkpoint. We have to pick some point that's going through and make sure it's really true. How about 0, 0? Let's check 0, 0 in y is greater than negative 1. And you say, well, what do I put in for x? Well, there is no x to plug in, so you simply plug in the y value of that order pair. So the y value is 0. And is 0 greater than negative 1? Yes. So 0, 0 is a solution, and I've got the right side shaded. Here's the next one. How about you do this one on your own, all the way through? Y is less than or equal to 2. So put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Step one is to graph y equals 2. And will that be a solid line or a dotted line? In other words, if it's part of the solution, it's a solid line. And yes, see this equal sign here? Y equals 2 is part of the solution. So we're going to graph y equals 2 and use a solid line. And where is that? Up 2. So those are certainly solutions on this. For instance, try anything like this ordered pair 1, 2 right here. If you put in 1 for x and I'm sorry, you put in 1 for x, which isn't even there, right? And 2 for y, is 2 less than or equal to 2? Yes. Convince yourself that any ordered pair on here, and remember you only have to plug in the y value, makes this inequality true. So that's part of it. Now we have to decide what side to shade. Well, it says y is less, so I want all the y values less than that. So is it going to be above or below the line? Hopefully you figured this out. It's going to be below the line. And let's check something. It goes through and makes sure that it really is a solution to this inequality. And since it goes through 0, 0, I'm going to go ahead and use that. I always use 0, 0 if possible. Otherwise, I just pick something else. So if we choose 0, 0 into y is less than or equal to 2, we're putting in 0 for y and making sure that makes a true inequality. And it does. So I do have the correct graph. Third one, x is greater than or equal to 3. Okay, Let's see if you can remember how to do this on your own. Go ahead and put the video on pause and try it on your own first. You're going to have to graph x equals 3 this time. And is it going to be a solid line or a dotted line? In other words, is x equal 3 or all those points on the graph? And yes, because of that equal sign. So you're going to use a solid line. Did you remember how to graph x equals 3? It just means you can easily make up some ordered pairs. Remember where x is always 3, right? And then pick anything you want for y. And if you do those 3 points, if you forget what x equals 3 looks like, you could always make a little chart like that. 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 0, etc. That is the vertical line. This one you can't put in slope-intercept form because there's no y value. There's no y in the inequality, so you can't solve for y. So the vertical line is the only line that is in the form just x in some number. Okay, now what side are we going to shade? Well, it says x is bigger than 3, right? So what do you think? Shade on the right side or left side of that line? Should be the right side. Because we want to pick values of x that are bigger, and x gets bigger as you go to the right. But let's double check. Oops, I went through x equals 4. My mistake. Sorry. Okay, so here we go. It's actually right here. Right, so let's pick this ordered pair right here, 4, 0. Let's check 4, 0 in this. And actually, we don't need the equal. We already took care of that. So we want to make sure we pick something that's going to be bigger than 3. So we're going to put in what for x? 4. There's no y value to plug in, right? There's a y value to plug in, but there's no y to plug it into. So I've got 4 greater than 3. Is that true? Yep. So I've got it shaded on the right side. Right being the correct side and on the right. Right being used two ways there. Okay, last one. X is less than 0. All right, try this one on your own first. All right, first you're going to graph x equals 0, but is that part of your solution, x equals 0, that line? Remember, it's not just a point. No, because there's no equal sign here, so we've got to use a dotted line. Now, where is x equals 0? Anybody remember that one? That is the entire y-axis. So that's a little bit tricky, but you have to just show you really want it dotted. It's hard to really see on here, but I'm dotting it. And now we want x is less than 0, so we want all the x values to be smaller than 0. Will that be to the left or the right? Should be to the left. Let's make sure that one of the ordered pairs the shading goes through is really a solution. So let's check. All right, it doesn't matter what order pair you do. How about negative 2, 0? So we're going to plug that into this. So in for x, I'm going to plug in negative 2 is less than 0. And is that true? And voila! So these are our special cases that actually should be easier to graph, but a lot of people just get stuck when they don't see an x and a y. So we've done all four problems. And in the next video, we're going to do ones that have some x's and y's again. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.